Sylvia went to McKinsey. But in 1992, a little-known governor at that time from Arkansas, and Bill Clinton, decided he was going to run for president, one of seven people running it at a time when President Bush had 70% favorability of the first Bush, had 70% favorability ratings after the first Gulf War. And unbeknownst to either one of us, we're now 25 years old, we both signed up to work for that campaign and left behind the path that we were on. Both signed up to do policy for him, and we were one of five, you know, he's signing up people at a time where you have to move a little rock to pay virtually nothing. So I'm sure we were like the 30th person to ask to finally say yes. But there was only five of us, and she was doing economic policy, and I was doing health and social policy. And we made it through the primaries and then through the general election. And we got to be working on problems that were meaningful to the places and people we'd come from. We even shared an apartment, barely finished, barely used. We were working around the clock, and we're completely energized by the possibility of doing work that might have meaning for where we come from. After the election, we both joined the administration, and after 1 year, our paths diverged. When the Clinton health plan was defeated, I was working on that plan. I was offered work on other domestic issues, but I decided to return to medical school. I was nervous about giving up on a clear career path. I was fired up about the ideas and the impact. But the other thing is I did not love the battle. I did not love the fact that I was battling not only with people who might be opposed, even with people who agreed with me, but the backbiting, the power struggles. I didn't like it. Now, Sylvia was interesting because she had a completely different attitude about that. Number one, all the time I've known her, she has never had a career plan. Let that give hope to some of you. She had extraordinary patience. She would wait out the battles. Opposition only made her gear up more. Where it depressed me, it fired her up. She could build a team with anybody in 8 years. Remember, we landed there at 25 years old. In 8 years, she was the deputy chief of staff at the White House. Then she goes on to Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, where she focuses on the global government development program for the poorest countries on Earth, then comes back, serves 8 years for Obama as budget director, secretary of health and human services. And what I've observed all the way through this time is the three things remain the same. Number one, still no discernible career path. An astonishing ability to build a team with anybody. This was as polarizing a time as you could find when she came to the Obama administration. She won a unanimous vote by the Senate to become the chief of the Office of Management and Budget. And then when she's running for, then she's up for confirmation as the Secretary of Health and Human Services, they have announced that because of Obamacare, they are opposed to her, and by the end of it, she has a 78-17 vote to be Secretary of Health and Human Services.